do we put weight in things like a Grammy or the amount of number ones?
I really try not to, and I'll tell you why. With all due respect to the Recording Academy, I respect them so greatly, and to Billboard, whom I also respect so greatly, I didn't come into this business being driven towards things like that. Like, I just wanted to sing. All I ever wanted to do was sing and write and perform and dance around and make music. I've loved singing my entire life. Since I was able to talk, I was able to sing. That's all I ever wanted. So I never really gave a I never wanted to do photo shoots. I never wanted to do red carpets. Hate it. Hate it. Hate it. Literally, my pants. Hate it. Every picture's ugly. Take me home. I can't be here. I just want to sing. All I want to do is be in a room with the lights off and sing. And that's all I've ever wanted. I'm honored to be acknowledged. I'm honored to have had my first two number ones with my friends that are in this room. It's very exciting. It's very exciting when it happens.
Yeah.
It really is. And I'm not going to pretend like it's not, because it is. And it's wonderful. It's a really great feeling. But I don't like that becoming something that's like of importance, because it's not. It doesn't make me any greater of an artist or lesser of an artist, because all of my favorite albums don't have Grammys. All of my favorite artists didn't have Grammys or number ones for... Actually, I don't think any of my favorite artists have number ones except Madonna.
Yeah, I was going to say, how many number ones does Imogen Heap have?
None.
Yeah.
I think the closest she came to it was because Jason Derulo featured Hide and Seek, sampled Hide and Seek, and that's like not even my favorite song of hers. Hide and Seek is one of my favorite songs in the world, but of hers, I love her whole entire discography equally.
Number
like
one,
even the songs she wrote for her baby, Scout.
Number ones and a Grammy doesn't make a good record or not. It doesn't.
I don't think so, because at home, as a viewer watching the Grammys every year, I'm always like, what? Literally, every year I'm like, what the f***? I always am rooting for my favorite albums.
Yeah.
And I know that people at home feel the same way. And I know that when I win a Grammy one day, people at home are going to be like, man, f*** that album and her ponytail. So it's fine. I don't think it makes or breaks anything. I think that there is music that feels good to people, and there is music that doesn't. And I think that it's very nice to be honored by the Recording Academy, but I think that it's something that I don't want to become too important to me, because I, at the end of the day, my favorite music doesn't, none of my favorite albums or songs or artists really have Grammys.
There's a lot of people who put beyond a lot of weight on the Grammy, and a lot of people I know kind of their career and their music weighs in the balance of if they're going to get a Grammy or not, or if they're
going to
get nominated or not. I kind of question why you do it then. People who feel like they need a Grammy or a nomination to continue.
Of course, because it's a Grammy. It's a huge thing. I'm just saying I don't want it to be like the driving force in what I'm creating. I want my driving force in what I'm creating to be how it makes me feel. What is this going to do for my soul? How is this going to make other people feel? And how, when I'm 90, am I gonna feel looking back on this? Am I gonna wish I had sung that differently? Or that's really like, I don't wanna go to begin with. I don't like going to things. Oh my God.
It's the lead up
stress.
My
anxiety, oh my God.
I know.
I can't handle it. Also, I'm so bad at like red carpets.